imagine that you have an inner algorithm that ends up, it's in Python and it's very slow. You might have to end up to implement it in a different way. And the different ways that are available, I put here a topology. One is to use an external library. So if you want to do a linear regression, you can just use NumPy and be done with it. We don't have to implement it yourself. You can also use lower level languages like C, Rust, Fortran, C++, Go, or Cython. And Cython is a low-level language. I'll get to it in a minute. You can use alternative Python implementations, but I don't think this is really very relevant. And then you have another thing that's called Number, which is a just-in-time compiler that will take your code and write it in an optimized way. That is actually an avenue that I invite everybody to explore, and that I will explore in the book in several parts, but I won't talk about it here. What I want to talk about is we need to implement something faster, and we need to do it in another language. Actually, there is another language which is called Cython, and it's a superset of Python, which essentially most Python programs, they are immediately Cython programs. And I'm just going to show you. This is an example from the book where I do an image filter. It really doesn't matter, but this is the Python code, which I call naive here. And this is just the point here is this is standard Python code, which is also Cython code. But then the question would be, well, if it is as easy to just call Cython, well, why don't we just call Cython all the time? If you run this code through Cython, which is, again, normal Python code, which Cython can mostly run, you see that you get no performance advantage. And the reason you don't get any performance advantage is that when we pass all these objects here, Cython will think, okay, these are Python objects. So I write C code because that's what Cython does. It writes C code. You can actually have a look at the C code that is generated. And unfortunately, sometimes you need to. These are Python objects. So I'm going to assume that they are Python objects. I'm going to assume that they are Python objects. And as such, I cannot release the global interpreter lock. I'll have to use Python methods. And for example, something as, if you see at C code generation for a function like this, and I will spare you the pain here, but you can do, Cython will let you do, and it gives you mechanisms to do it in a relatively painless way. You see that the code generated here has a lot of Python release, that Python call this, and it's extremely, extremely slow. So what you need to do, you can actually, there are lots of things you can do, but one of the things that you need to do is to do type annotations. And these type annotations are not standard Python annotations, okay? These Python annotations are specific to Cython, and you see an example here. So you are saying an image is composed of, it's an array of unsigned integers of fate bits, and it has a dimension of 3, because an image is, it has two dimensions, but then it has a red, green, and blue component, so it's actually 3, it's 3D. And then we have a filter image, which is more or less the same thing, but because it's a filter, it just needs a single number. And this will allow Cython, okay, to see, these are not general Python. These are not general Python objects, so I can be slightly smarter here. So I don't need to do lots of things. And Cython actually knows a lot about NumPy, because almost all other libraries know a lot of NumPy. And you can actually say, okay, this is a NumPy array, and Cython will know how to optimize code specifically for it, and maybe even bypass Python completely. And this is a first step, but after that, there are some more steps that you need to do in terms of. So, by the way, you also need to type the local declarations to help, and you have to type it before usage. Then there are a few restrictions that you have to be able to deal with. For example, the way you refer objects here, you see how we are computing the mean. This is slightly more efficient, and so on and so forth. So the point here is Cython. If you don't know any other, if you know C or Rust or whatever, and you are comfortable with that, and you need to do a low-level implementation, then go ahead and use that. There are tools to help you with that, and you should use that. But if you don't know any low-level programming language, Cython, it's reasonably easy to use. It's a compiled language. It has a few quirks. I go through some of them in the book so that you can import the code easily. And it will allow you to write Python-ish codes that is actually C code, and it's directly translated to C. And if you are careful enough, you type everything. It's one of the things that you need to do. And a few others, you can write mostly Python code that is translated to very efficient code. And because it's C code, it can release the global interpreter lock, so it can be used in it can be parallelized.